This is a cartoon of bone. We're all familiar with the cartoon of the bone. Why has it got those lumpy ends? It's for muscle to attach to. So if we've got a muscle here, it attaches. So now we're looking at the skeletal muscle group. Every muscle, especially like in arms and legs and things like that, they will start at a bone and they'll end at a bone. And that's what makes our limbs move. They change. Here's my model of a muscle. There you go, just blew up the balloon. That does actually make quite a good model. So the muscle that everyone is usually familiar with is bicep. And if you put your arm there and do that, you can feel it moving. So when it's like that, the muscle is going like that. And when you see the bodybuilders and the show-offs doing all this sort of stuff, what's happening is that it's coming together like that. It's pulling in. And this is when I did go to uni and do a little bit of this, this is where suddenly the light switched on and goes, oh, that's what's happening. So what's happening is, if this is a limb, a leg or an arm, and it wants to pull it that way, it's going to come in here and swell that way. You know, balloon out, because it's dragging it in. So that's, while that's going up like that, it is pulling the muscle in both ways. So for the artist, it makes it very interesting because you're not just drawing a statue. A statue is easy, something made out of marble, because it's not going to change. But something more organic is constantly changing. And one of the more complicated parts is the arm, especially when we get down to this part of the arm. So I'm going to run through some of the muscle groups. To do with the arm and how the arm works. Last week, we looked at the clavicles and we looked at the scapulars. What we notice on the scapula here, so he's got these two ridges there, and that is especially for doing the top muscle. So, here, so sort of what we covered last week was the neck, trapezius, that. When we look at the skeleton now, we've got like a rib cage here. The collar bone, the clavicle, and the scapula tend to sort of come together to form the socket there for our humerus. And to be able to do that, that, or that, it takes a main muscle group, which is the deltoids. So let's just stick in this bone. This side. Deltoid tends to look like that, and the bicep tends to be there before we get into the forearms. That's the general appearance of them. So you've got this thing up here that looks like sort of like a teardrop going up that way, then you've got this sort of oval here, which is the bicep. But this is a bit more complicated than just a teardrop. On some people, yeah, it just sort of looks like some cap there on their shoulder coming out from there. On other people, you'll find that these things are a bit different. So like some people have like a little ball for a bicep and some people have it like an oval for a bicep. Some people have a gap there, some people don't. So everybody's a little bit different. With the deltoid, there's three parts of it. Okay, looking at the front here, our collarbone there, our clavicle. The first part, or the front part, attaches to that. So that's our front delt. Off the side here, which makes your arms go out like that quite easily, is the middle one, the mid delt, and that can often drop down a bit. So, where this socket comes together, you've got this attaching to the collarbone. This one can often drop down a little bit. So it starts at that junction there. Where it ends up, it's interesting because it ends up this muscle here, this bone here, it's got a little bit of a rise up there, a little bit that dips up. That's where it attaches to there. So that little dip, so it's not a straight bone, it's a little bit of a tiny raised up bit there, little hill there, that's where the deltoid ends. And so when that deltoid squeezes in, that arm comes up. If it squeezes up here, it comes forward. We're going to work on the core muscles next week, but just a quick bit with the pectoral muscles, the chest muscles, is that they slip in underneath that front delt. And sometimes they both work together. So when we're talking arms, we're really also talking the top part of the chest to move the arm around. Likewise on the back. So there's two parts of the deltoid there. If we look at the back, so let's put Boney around here. You see that bit there on that scapula? It's got like a ridge there. Let's see where you are. And we've got our middle delt going there. The other delts around there on the front. Then we've got on the scapula here, again about halfway over, we've got what's called the rear delt, the rear part of the deltoid. Again, I would expect the mid one to drop down a little bit further. So now think of them as three teardrops all pointing upwards. Whenever you're looking at things, just try and break them down into simple shapes. So, you know, what you got? You've got teardrops going like this. So look for those shapes when we're drawing. Also look for the top part of the junction there, which often you can see. Sometimes the delt seems to just be one great big lump, and it's hard to distinguish those three sections. Other times you see them very clearly. So we're all different, and it doesn't matter how much you work out or how much you don't work out, we are all different, and sometimes these body types are going to look different. So then we have our bicep here. It's got a bicep because it's actually two parts of the muscle. And again, we don't normally see it, we normally just see it as one. Unless there's an extreme bodybuilder, sometimes you sort of see this where one's a little bit longer than the other. And that's why sometimes you see the bodybuilders that are doing that. It looks like a tennis ball or something sort of floating on top of the bicep. That's one of them, that's the shorter one. There's a longer one which fills up the arm. There's a gap there. Now around the back here, there we have our triceps. So these crashing into each other a bit here. This bone here is very wide there. That's where our triceps connect to. Down a little bit more. With the triceps, it tends to be like a horseshoe shape. And you only tend to see that if somebody's sort of like, you know, if somebody's sitting down and they've got their hand back like that, reclining like that, you're probably going to see a tricep there. And you'll see a bit of a horseshoe shape. Coming down there. Because that's the tricep when it's fully contracted. When it sort of goes like that, goes up, and goes into a horseshoe shape. When it's relaxed, it just tends to be a bit more relaxed like that. Now there's three parts of it, but it only looks like there's two parts. There's a small bit in there, but visually it only looks like there's just two, the other way to think of it, two teardrops coming down. But again, look at this. Look at the flow here. I'm going to draw this flow there. See that sort of flowing thing that's happening there? So if you knew nothing about muscles, you'd notice, actually sort of more skin on it. You'd notice there's this sort of nice flowing thing happening. So that's the other thing to look for. So I don't expect everybody to memorize or know all of this. I do it every year. So like the diploma is going to get this afternoon as well. I don't expect you to know it all. What I'm trying to do is give you an overall view of bits, different parts of the body. Each week we're going to try and draw these parts and so that we can hopefully know a little bit more. Now we're about, this is the easy bit. We're about to get into the hard bit. Because most of the time, move the bones around, the muscles all change. But there is one part of the body where the bones move, which makes it sort of irritating to draw. If you have your hands like that, there's two bones running through there, pretty much like that. Pretty much like that, you got two bones running through. You do that, what happens? So that happens. Bones cross over each other. How annoying is that when you're trying to draw it? So there's a few things to look out for here. If you look at your hand there, you feel, see that bone there? Everyone has that bone. Okay, a handy thing to remember is that it always follows the little finger. See, now it's on that side. Bone's there, and it's there. You just feel it moving around. You have an interesting muscle here. The forearm muscles are very complicated because they're attached to these things that do complicated things. I mean, look at that. There's no other part of the body that does that, is there? Okay, that's just crazy. The things you can do with your hands is just, you know, it's insane what you can do with your hands. Compared to a horse, they can't do much. But we can do quite a lot, and therefore we have extremely complicated muscles in this part of the body and bones to be able to perform this. We have a muscle here, the brachialis, which is the big linking muscle between the top and the bottom sets of bones here. So that lump there where the deltoid ends there, the brachialis comes through and connects it all. So if you sort of, you know, push up like that, You can often see it just happening there. It gives that forearm that Popeye look. You don't get the Popeye look unless that forearm's working there. We use that muscle all the time. So not only are we using our biceps when we lift our arms up like that, we're also using that arm, especially if you're grabbing something and lifting it up like that, you're using that muscle much more. We have another interesting lot of muscles on the top part of our arm, which all link up to our fingers. And so, if you sort of do that, usually you can sort of see things moving on your arm, like those little critters under there wriggling. And that's all sort of like those things that drawstring the fingers. So imagine, and it's really interesting when you see these things in real life, it just sort of looks like some sort of thin plastic tape. Or if you've seen turkey leg, you know, all those sinewy bits. Okay. Imagine those are all down here. Okay, and this muscle is going to pull them. It's going to like a drawstring, draw things up. We have other ones under here which does that. So our hands are pretty much a hinge. The hand's probably not as complicated as you think, because the hand itself can't do that. It's actually the forearm doing that. So what to look for? Now put this all together at some stage very shortly. Know that our forearm tends to have one big thing there, and it follows the thumb around pretty much. Wherever your thumb is, that's usually where that is. You got a bone there, it's usually where your little finger is. You're looking for those shapes. Let's throw it all together and show you what I want to look at. What I want you guys to look at today. We'll get our model in place. Let me just draw a person. So I just quickly knock that up there. What I am looking at here, now you gotta remember everything you learned last week as well. There's a bit of a deltoid there. We've got bones there, we know there's a bit of a deltoid at the front there. This arm's now bent, so that bicep's just gonna be bulging a little bit. At the back there, the tricep's gonna be so relaxed. The forearm here, this muscle might just be bulging a little bit. The elbow, little bone there. Then we work onto the hands, which we're going to do it another day. Up here. Bad delts and front part's probably swollen a little bit because it's lifting that front arm. This bicep is stretched right out, so it's now not swelling, it's thin. We've got, let's see, there's a thumb there. So we've got muscle there. Groups of other muscles under it. Maybe a bit of elbow there. More like a hand. The other thing you may notice on thin people are veins. Veins are a bit like fingerprints, they can be all over the place. There's certain places where the veins will have a junction. One of those places is right in there. So we usually have a large vein there, and from there it can just sort of like, it can just branch off. But like I say, just sort of look for these visual clues. Like I say, some people's bicep is, they have what they call bicep gap, and it's a little bit there like that. So it depends on the person.
Okay, we'll get our model ready now.
Did you find it useful last week when we did this and then drew?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
It is useful. Mm-hmm. I'm not wasting my time then.
No.
Okay, you're very quiet today.
Oh, you're
quiet. It's not a waste of time, it's very interesting.
Yeah.
It's a lot to take in. And that's why I do it every year.
Yeah.
For every level, so.